welcome class 10 to the merchant of venice by william shakespeare act 4 scene 1 part 5 so children in the previous video I've been teaching you about how shylock was confident that no one could take away his right to forfeiture since the strict exposition of the law of venice permits it portia the lawyer has already stated that the law cannot be altered to save Antonio, as it would set forth bad precedents, means bad examples, in the administration of justice, and Shylock's deep-rooted hatred for Antonio and his determination to have his bond as per the agreement, according to the agreement, are shown over here. So children, coming to our, let's proceed forward from where we have left. Line number 265 onwards. This was the last speech we were doing. I his breast, so says the bond. Doth it not, noble Jew, noble judge? Nearest the heart. Those are the very words. So Shylock says, yes, I have to cut the pound of flesh near his breast, near his heart of Antonio. So says the bond. This is how it is mentioned in the bond. Doth it not, noble judge? Isn't it, noble judge? So he's addressing Portia, who is in the disguise of Dr. Balthazar, not knowing that she is a girl. Nearest his heart, those are the very words. So the words are quoted. These are the very words which are mentioned in the bond. He says, nearest his heart. Nearest the heart of Antonio, where I am going to cut the pound of flesh. So now we are going to proceed forward. Portia, it is so. Are there balance here to weigh the flesh? Portia repeats, yes, this is how it is mentioned in the bond. Then she asks him, are there balance or scales or the weighing machine? Have you made arrangement for that in order to weigh the pound of flesh? Maybe because it is mentioned, it is already decided that he is going to cut 1 pound of flesh from the body of Antonio near his heart. See the height of cruelty. Shylock is already ready with them. He says, I have them ready. Yes, I brought the scales with me. Portia, have by some surgeon, Shylock, on your charge to stop his wounds. Let he do bleed to death. Then she advises him that on your charge, at your expense, Shylock, you should arrange to have some surgeon, a doctor, to stop his wound. Who can stop the wounds? Because you're going to cut a pound of flesh. And because of the cut, he will bleed. Maybe so much blood can be lost from his body, which can lead to his death. So in order to stop that, you should make arrangement for some surgeon. Now Shylock, of course, Shylock is not prepared for that. He is all ready to kill Antonio. He says, is it so nominated in the bond? So he's baffled. He says, oh, is it so mentioned in the bond? Portia, it is not so expressed, but what of that? She says, even though it is not nominated in the bond, even though it is not mentioned in the bond, but so what? Twere good you do so much for charity. Means so much good you can do out of kindness. Because to show humanity, you are a human being, this much good is expected out of you. Shylock says, I cannot find it. It is not in the bond. So he's frantically looking into the bond. He says, oh, I can't find anything written in the bond pertaining to this. It is not there in the bond that I should have to make arrangement for some surgeon. Portia says, come merchant, have you anything to say? Now Portia instructs Antonio also that come ahead and do you have anything to say before Shylock proceed to cut the pound of flesh near your heart? Means of course you should be prepared to die. Antonio, remember, Antonio's character is a passive character. He has resigned himself to his fate. So he says, Antonio is already ready. He has given up all hope. But little, he says, I have nothing to say. Little means nothing. I am armed and well prepared. Give me your hand, Bassanio. Fare you well. He says, I am armed. I am prepared for my fate. I am prepared spiritually and whatever is going to follow, whatever lies in my future, in my fate, I am ready to face that. Of course, Bassanio and the rest are sulking and Bassanio is very sad and not able to do anything, on the verge of crying and very emotional. He says, give me your hand, Bassanio. Fare you well. Goodbye to you, Bassanio. Give me your hand. He holds his hand. That means. Then, see, this shows how much Antonio loves Bassanio, even in the hour of dying. And that too, of course, it is because of Bassanio. He is not ready. He doesn't want Bassanio to feel sad, even if Antonio dies on account of him. He says, grieve not that I am fallen to this for you. For herein fortune shows herself more kind than is her custom. It is still her use to let the wretched man outlive his wealth, to view with hollow eye and wrinkled brow an age of poverty, from which lingering penance of such misery doth she cut me off. Till here, let me explain first. These lines are important, children. Grieve not. So he is telling Bassanio, of course Bassanio is all grieving and sorry. He says, he's speaking these words to Bassanio, saying, Bassanio, please don't grieve. Grieve not that I am fallen to this for you. Do not be sad that I have come to this, I have incurred this fate because of you. For herein fortune shows herself more kind than is a custom. Because, for always means because in Shakespeare, because here fortune refers to the mythological character in Roman mythology. Fortune refers to the goddess Fortune. Romans believed in many gods and goddesses as Hindu mythology. And he says, because goddess Fortune, it is a character of goddess Fortune to always bestow the fortune or fate upon the people on this earth, and it is a normal habit to allow a man in misfortune to live, to see with his hollow eye and with his wrinkled face the ruin which has come upon him. Let me explain again. He says, herein fortune shows herself more kind. Goddess Fortune is proving herself to be more kind than it is her habit, than it usually does. It is still her use to let the wretched man outlive his wealth, to view with hollow eye and wrinkled brow an age of poverty. Till here, first you see and try to understand. Because it is still her use, still it is a custom, it is her habit to let or to allow a man who is in misfortune to live, to see with his hollow eyes. Hollowed eyes, because when a man falls to his fate, he's poverty ridden, has lost his riches, how does he become? All his hollows, his eyes are sunken into hollows and his face wrinkles. So it is a custom, it is a habit to let a man live a long life and see with his hollow eyes, with his wrinkled face, the ruin, view with hollow eye and wrinkled face, the age of poverty, to see the ruin which has come upon him, and to endure with old age the hardships and the sufferings which come along with poverty, from which lingering penance means prolonged suffering, the suffering which prolongs. A man who loses all his riches becomes poor and is allowed to live by goddess Fortune longer, so that he suffers, his suffering is prolonged as long as he lives. So he says, from this prolonged suffering, what is goddess Fortune doing? Of such misery doth she cut me off. Of this prolonged misery, she cuts me off. She cuts my fortune. She cuts my life. She makes my life less. He thinks that, according to Antonio, Fortune is so kind to him by mercifully letting him escape a prolonged suffering of his misfortune by awarding him an early death. So that an early death which is being awarded to him, he is being letting escape from that by goddess Fortune, who is showing her mercy upon him. Till here, these lines are quite important. Try to understand them. What role goddess Fortune plays and how is she being more merciful to in the case of Antonio. Then he changes the subject and he tells Bassanio, come on Bassanio, commend me to your honorable wife. Give my greetings, my regards to your honorable wife. Who is honorable wife? Of Bassanio, Portia, because Antonio has never met her. But he knows that Antonio is now married. She is in Belmont. He says, give my regards, give my greetings to your honorable wife. Tell her the process of Antonio's end. And after I die, when you go, tell her the manner in which Antonio, means I, met his fate, his end, how I died for you. Say how I loved you. Speak me fair in death. And when the tale is told, bid her be judged whether Bassanio had not once a love. Says, tell her the manner in which I lost my life for your sake. And tell her how much I loved you. And speak to me. Speak me. Mean about me. When you are speaking about me to your wife, Portia, tell her about me in a kind and well manner. When the tale is told, tell me story. And when you have told my story, then tell her to judge me. Tell her to be the judge. Tell her to judge me whether you, Bassanio, had a real friend or not in me. Repent not that you shall lose your friend. And he repents not that he pays your debt. He says, come on, Bassanio, no need to repent for me. There is no need for you to repent for me because I do not repent at all in paying your debt, even at the expense of my life. For if the Jew do cut but deep enough, I will pay it instantly with all my heart. Because even if Shylock the Jew do cut while cutting the pound of flesh near my heart, if the cut is deep enough, instantly at once I'm going to pay with all my heart, I will die. There's a pun on it, heart. There's a double meaning. It's given in your books as well. There are two meanings. One meaning is the literal meaning, other is the emotional meaning. The literally, he means to say that if Shylock cuts the pound of flesh and the cut is too deep, then I am going to die instantly with all my heart. The organ, with the help of my organ heart, I will instantly pay the debt which I have incurred. Emotionally means to say that Antonio says, I am ready to give all for the sake of you, my friend Bassanio. For your sake, I am ready to give everything from my heart, everything, whatever I can give for your love to the Jew. Now Bassanio, of course Bassanio is all grieved and very much sad and not knowing what to say and what to do. He says, Antonio, I am married to a wife which is as dear to me as life itself. But life itself, my wife and all the world are not with me esteemed above thy life. I would lose all, I sacrifice them all here to this devil to deliver you. He says, Antonio, though I am married, because the matter of the subject of the conversation has now shifted to Portia. He says, yes, Antonio, I am married to Portia as a wife. She is as a wife, which is, of course, we don't say in the proper English, we don't say which, who. It should be who is as dear to me as life itself. She is, my wife is as dear to me as life. But everything together, my life, my wife, and everything, all the riches of the world, all together are not with me esteemed upon my life. I do not value all these things together above your life, Bassanio. So these lines shows Bassanio's deep love and friendship for Antonio. You might be asked, like, what trait of character do we find here of Bassanio? Bassanio's deep love for Antonio, his friendship for Antonio. I would lose all. He says, I am ready to lose everything for your sake, Antonio. Sacrifice everything to this devil, Shylock, in order to free you from his clutches. Now, Portia is standing and listening, of course. The subject of the conversation is she herself. Of course, they do not know because she is disguised as Dr. Balthazar, the lawyer. So, she quips him, sarcastic. Your wife would give you little thanks for that. If she were by to hear you make the offer, so there's a sense of a pinch of humor also, a tinge of humor. She says, she's addressing Bassanio. Your wife would give you little thanks for that. If your wife were nearby and she were to hear you, what offer you are making, what offer you're ready to make, if it is possible for you, then of course your wife will not be thankful for that. She will be angry with you for what you are saying. Now Gratiano is not to be left behind, of course. He has to do whatever his friend and master Bassanio does. And so he says, I have a wife whom I protest I love. I would she were in heaven, so that she could entreat some power to change this courage to you. He says, even I have a wife whom I protest. I protest means I tell for sure that I love her. I would she were in heaven. Would means wish. And I wish at this moment my wife. His wife is Nerissa. Remember, Nerissa is also standing over here as the clerk. She is also disguised as the clerk of Portia. He says, I have a wife and I protest that of course I love her, and even then I wish she were in heaven. She was in heaven. She was with God, means dead and gone. Why? Because so that she could entreat some power to change this courage you. So that, because if she were in heaven, she could at least persuade some heavenly power over there, some God over there in heaven, to change the mind of this dog like, this vile Jew, Shylock. To this Jew Shylock, at least his mind could be changed, his heart would be changed. Then Nerissa, the sarcastic Nerissa, also quips in to what her husband is saying. She says, 'Tis well you offer it behind a back. The wish would make else in an quiet house. It's better that the offer which you are making is behind the back of your wife. Behind her, she is not there to listen, to hear what you are saying. The wish would make else. Otherwise, this wish you are making, it is going to make an unquiet house. It is going to give rise to a strife in your house. This is going to make a scuffle in your house, disturb the peace of your house. Means, of course, your wife is going to fight with you. Now, Shylock is there listening to all this. Of course, all others are listening. But Shylock is really aside, he says. Shylock was stunned. See, he is very much grieved that his daughter Jessica has eloped with a Christian. Aside. This is a figure of speech. Remember, children. Aside means, just like soliloquy and aside are two different figure of speech. Like in soliloquy, the character speaks in his mind. Aside, the character is supposed to be speaking to himself. But there are other characters on the stage who cannot hear him, who are not supposed to hear him. Remember, everything is taking place on the stage. So Shylock is speaking aside loudly so that the audience can hear, but it is understood that all the other characters who are standing on the stage cannot hear what Shylock is saying. So he's speaking to himself. He says, these be the Christian husbands. I have a daughter. Would any of the stock of Barabbas had been her husband rather than a Christian? He's speaking to himself. Oh, this is what Christian husbands are like. Even I have a daughter, Jessica. Who? So he's referring to Jessica. Would any of the stock of Barabbas had been her husband? Would means I wish any of the descendant of Barabbas. Barabbas is supposed to be the notorious criminal in the Holy Bible. I'll just give the reference. So I wish that she would have married to the descendant of the notorious criminal Barabbas instead of marrying a Christian husband, Lorenzo. Instead of marrying a Christian, he is a fanatic Jew. So he is not even ready to admit that his daughter could have married a Christian. So Barabbas, in your books also it is given, in all the four Gospels, children, see, Barabbas was a criminal. When the governor of Judah, Pontius Pilate, asked the mob to choose between Barabbas and Christ, they chose Barabbas to be freed and Christ to be crucified. So here Shylock wishes that Jessica had married a descendant of Barabbas rather than a Christian. He would have preferred that. Then he speaks loudly. Aloud. He speaks loudly now. We trifle time. I pray thee pursue sentence. He is more or less addressing Portia. Dr. Balthazar says, come on, we are wasting time. I request you, come on, give the verdict. Go on with the verdict. Portia at once says, yes. A pound of that same merchant's flesh is thine. The court awards it and the law doth give it. Says, yes, a pound of that same merchant, this merchant, Antonio standing here, his, a pound of his flesh is yours. And according to the court and the law, you can have it. Now, Shylock is elated, very happy. Says, most rightful judge, you are the most rightful judge ever. Portia says, and you must cut this flesh from off his breast. The law awards it and the court awards it. You are allowed by the court, by the law as well as the court. You can have your pound of flesh near the heart of Antonio. Shylock, most learned judge, a sentence, come prepare. Shylock exclaims, he's very happy. Oh, you are a most learned judge. And this is what is called a sentence. And then he challenges Antonio, come on, prepare. Prepare, how to prepare? Means take off your shirt and lay bare your bosom for my knife. Now, as Shylock is ready with his knife and he must have put the knife to the breast of Antonio, then, of course, you can understand the climax. You can feel the climax. Everybody in the court must be on tenterhooks and must be anxious, must be worried. What next? And Antonio resigned to his fate, ready to die. But Shylock, elated. Portia, see how the tables are turned in an instant by the wise judge in the guise of Portia. She says, tarry a little. There is something else. This bond doth give thee, give here no jot of blood. The words expressly are a pound of flesh. Take then thy bond. Take thou thy pound of flesh. But in the cutting of it, if thou dost shed one drop of Christian blood, thy lands and goods are by the laws of Venice confiscated unto the state of Venice. Now see, children, this is the most very important speech. The climax of the play, we can say, where the tables are turned against Shylock by this sentence which is pronounced by Portia in an instant. When everything seems to be against Shylock, everyone is on the point of anxiety. And Portia has already told Shylock to take the pound of flesh, but at the crucial moment, at the most critical moment, she says, wait, Jim, wait a little, just wait a while. There is something else. Apart from you carving a pound of flesh from Antonio's body near the breast, something else is there. Wait. This bond doth give thee no jot of blood. This bond clearly expressly states that you can take just a pound of flesh. Take then thy bond. Take thou thy pound of flesh. But in the cutting of it, if thou dost shed one drop of Christian blood, thy land and goods are by laws of Venice confiscated unto the state of Venice. So Portia clearly states, interprets the laws of the law of Venice to Shylock, tell him that in the bond there is no mention of even the smallest drop of blood, and the word clearly says a pound of flesh. She tells Shylock to take the forfeit in this agreement, which is just a pound of flesh. And in this process of cutting, then if he shed a drop of blood of a citizen, that is here Antonio, then what will happen? All his wealth, means Shylock's wealth and his possessions, will be forfeited, seized by the government according to the law of Venice. They will be confiscated to the state of Venice. Now this is Gratiano's turn to jump with joy. He is elated. Just now they were all on tenterhooks. At once he is relieved of his tension and he says, O upright judge, marked you or learned judge. He exclaims the same words of Shylock repeats the same words of Shylock in the praise of Portia. Upright judge. You mark, Shylock, see, such a learned judge he is. Shylock is taken aback in an instant. Is that the law? Portia, thou shalt see that. For as thou urgest justice, be assured that thou shalt have justice more than thou desirest. Yes, you can see yourself the act, you can yourself see the decree which is laid down in the Act of Venice. Because as you have been urging for justice, you have been urging justice, you have been pleading so insistently for justice, then be assured, Shylock, you will have justice more than you have been wishing for. Justice is going to be more strict than you have been wishing for. You will have more of it. Aggression, oh learned judge, marked you, a learned judge. He is such a learned judge. Shylock. Now Shylock has no other way, no other option left. He says, I take this offer then. Pay the bond thrice and let the Christian. He says, okay, let me accept the offer made by Bassanio. Let me have 3 times the bond, 3 times the money, and let go Antonio. Bassanio at once. Here is the money. He at once is ready. He is ready with the money. At once grabs and says, take the money. 3 times the amount of money means 3,000 ducats it was due. 9,000 maybe is offering him. But Portia will not let Shylock have it. Portia says, soft, the Jew shall have all justice. Soft, no haste, he shall have nothing but the penalty. Portia says, wait. To Bassanio she says, wait, the Jew shall have all justice. He is going to have justice. Wait, make no hurry. He shall have nothing but only the penalty, only the punishment which is due to him from Antonio. Gratio, O Jew, an upright judge, a learned judge. He is saying, Shylock, see, what an upright judge, what a learned judge we have. Portia, therefore prepare thee to cut off the flesh. So Portia now bids Shylock that you should now prepare yourself, Shylock, to cut off the pound of flesh from the body of Antonio. Come on, prepare yourself. Shed thou no blood, nor cut thou less nor more, but just a pound of flesh. He says, you are going to cut not more nor less than just a pound of flesh. So Portia says that he should cut not more nor less than exactly a precisely a pound of flesh from the body of Antonio. If he fails in cutting that amount precisely, and if he cut more or less than an exact pound, means if it weighs lighter or heavier than even by the 20th part of a small grain, or if the scales of the beam, or the beam of the scales inclines, if the beam of the scales inclines to one side only by the breadth of an hair, then Shylock will suffer the penalty of death, and all the possessions of Shylock, all the goods of Shylock will be confiscated by the state of Venice. So Portia highlights another loophole in the bond, telling Shylock to be very careful to cut neither more nor less than exactly an amount of flesh as is mentioned in the bond. So till here, children, go through and try to understand. Rest in the next video. Till then, goodbye.